just want to do a quick video about the Conor McGregor versus Floyd Mayweather fight. I want to get to the point, cut to the chase. I think the fight was quite entertaining. I think Conor McGregor was carried. Now, there's a lot of people, MMA fans, who say things like, oh, but Conor McGregor lasted 10 rounds. That's fantastic, man. I didn't expect that to happen. But we all know that Floyd Mayweather wanted to make it an exciting fight for the fans, and because of that, he didn't, you know, he didn't move out of second gear. Basically, he allowed the fight to go on as it did because he wanted to make it an exciting fight for the fans because of the disappointment they experienced with Manny Pacquiao. And Floyd Mayweather said that himself. Where was the dominance with the jab? No cutting off the ring, no pull counter, no shoulder roll, no check hooks. All of his main weapons he didn't use because he didn't need to. It's similar to when I play table football with my two little sons and I let them score a couple of goals before I thrash them. That's exactly what's happened here. So, you know, let's not kid ourselves here and let's not think that Conor McGregor, you know, challenged Floyd in any way, because the fight was not in the least bit competitive. So if it lasted 10 rounds like Vladimir Klitschko versus Anthony Joshua and they went hammer and tong at each other and Floyd stopped him in the last minute, as did AJ to Klitschko, then you could say, hey, that was a fight. But the fact is, it wasn't very competitive at all. And the fact that it lasted 10 rounds is because Floyd allowed it to last 10 rounds. So it has nothing whatsoever to do with Conor being this excellent boxer. Fair play to Conor McGregor. He lasted quite long, you know, albeit Floyd allowed him to. He showed heart and, you know, you've got to give him credit where credit's due. But the fact is, don't, if you're an MMA fan, don't get too hyped about this, because in my opinion, I think McGregor carried him. Now, before the fight, a lot of these MMA guys were saying his awkward style is going to be very difficult for Floyd to figure out. He's taken shins to the head. He's taken elbows to the head. He's been choked out. So somebody like Floyd Mayweather, who's a brittle-fisted bitch, is not going to do him any justice. Now he's lost the fight, the same MMA fans are saying, oh, but we expect Floyd to beat him because Floyd's a boxer, you know, and he should have made it easier than what it was. But no, you weren't saying that before the fight. Before the fight, Conor was this machine. He was going to take over the boxing world, but the fact of the matter is, he didn't. And you know, I'm sorry to disappoint you, but he was carried. And it's as simple as that. And, you know, I didn't expect the fight to finish early. You know, I did predict that the fight would last 8 rounds. That's what I predicted. Teddy Atlas predicted 9. You know, because Floyd Mayweather is making it exciting, and because obviously Conor McGregor is a tough opponent, you know, as he says he's been in the octagon, he's faced kickboxers, Thai boxers. This was half a fight, so we didn't expect Floyd to go in there and knock him out completely. We expected him to you know, to go a few rounds, because, you know, he's a tough cookie. I didn't expect him to get knocked out in the first or second round. He's tough. You know, these MMA guys are, it's kind of a contradiction in terms. On the one hand, you're saying Conor's so tough, and on the other hand, you're saying, why didn't Floyd knock him out in 10 round, in one or two rounds, or in 3 rounds? Why did it take him 10 rounds? Because he's tough, obviously, according to your argumentation. That's the reason why. But, you know, based on what I saw the other night, I don't think Floyd used all of the tools in the armory, because he wanted to make it an exciting fight. And I'm sorry I'm laboring this point, but it just really, really shocks me that some of these guys thought that Conor McGregor actually had a chance against the best defensive boxer of all time. He didn't have a chance. And if he was, you know, if Floyd did use his defensive skills and he did fight him in the usual way, he would be criticized. He'll be criticized for running. He'll be criticized for being boring. So this time he wanted to give the fans a little something. But even still, even then, now, he still can't win, because there's guys on the other side of the fence who are saying, well, you know, he should have finished him earlier. And the fact he let a debutant go 10 rounds with him is a disgrace. But no, come on, let's not kid ourselves here. You know, he can't please everybody. And the fact remains, he's 40 years old. 40. Conor McGregor is 29. Floyd is 40. Hasn't fought in 23 months. He's way out of his prime. And he still managed to toy with Conor and beat Conor convincingly. So let's not kid ourselves. Let's not make out as if this was a victory for MMA, because it wasn't. Floyd schooled your boy. And, you know, this isn't to the hardcore MMA fans. This message isn't to the hardcore MMA fans, because there are some realistic fans out there who know the score. But these guys who never watch boxing, who claim to, you know, who claim to say that, you know, boxing is so shit and is not a very good sport, and completely have no respect for the sport whatsoever, those are the ones I'm talking to, who thought that it was going to be so easy for Conor McGregor to, on his debut, knock out and beat the most offensive boxer in of all time in four rounds. That is what annoys me. You don't watch boxing, but all of a sudden you're supposed to have this all-encompassing knowledge. You're a true martial artist. You know what real fighting is all about. But the very foundational aspect of fighting, boxing, you neglect. And you actually think that Conor McGregor can come and beat someone like Floyd Mayweather. So he was carried, and there's no question about it. And, you know, I'll probably do another video on it. I just wanted to do a quick video, because a lot of people are messaging me and talking all sorts of crap about how, you know, Conor McGregor did well to go 10 rounds. Come on, it was just a joke. Just an absolute joke. I'm glad it's over with. Roll on, GGG versus Canelo. Thanks. And also, and the figures have just come through, and it said, as did Dana White, that Conor McGregor landed more punches on Floyd Mayweather than Manny Pacquiao. So are you trying to tell me that Conor McGregor is a better boxer than Manny Pacquiao? He had more success on Floyd than Manny. That makes him a better boxer. Are you trying to say that? Of course, that's absolutely ludicrous that he landed a few more, that Canelo landed just a few more punches than Conor. You're trying to tell me that Conor is on Manny Pacquiao's level and on Canelo Alvarez's level? Of course not. Of course it doesn't. What does that tell you? It tells you that Conor McGregor was allowed to come forward by Floyd. It shows you that Floyd allowed him to come forward. It shows you that Floyd left all of his best punches, all of his best moves on the shelf for a night to make it an exciting fight for the fans. He was, you know, what would have happened if it wasn't competitive? The fans would have felt that they were ripped off. Of course he needed to make it look like it was competitive, so he could say, well, look, you know, it wasn't such a dud fight after all. Come on now, use your brains. It wasn't competitive. And, you know, anybody who believes that is just an idiot. I'm sorry. I just had to say that.